knowledge even further around nutrients. One of my passions as one of your global health educators is to help you as passionate USANA associates not just have better health yourselves, but to be able to go out there and make an even bigger difference in the world. Certainly one of my passions is to help people truly see and appreciate and live the experience of what life is like with optimum health and true nutrition, true health. Because when we step up and take even better care of ourselves as individuals, yes, we benefit from that. With less degenerative disease, embracing up to its vision of a world free from degenerative disease, we get better energy, we get better sleep. But think about what happens to your energy when you are optimally nourished. Think about what happens when you give yourself and your body the nutrients they need to function optimally. You bring energy to every situation you're part of. And what happens when you show up with energy? What do you do to the people who come into contact with you? You light them up as well. It's such a win-win. So today what I want to share with you is all around nutrient know-how. I wanted to bring to life some biochemistry that is so easy for you to understand, to help you to have more meaningful conversations with people, to help you take them further on their USANA journey as well. My personal approach to health and nutrition has three prongs to it: the biochemical, the nutritional, and the emotional. And today I'll be focused on that biochemistry and on the role that nutrients play in those biochemical processes. So this image represents some biochemical pathways in the body. Kind of looks like a train map, doesn't it? So the best way that I want you to imagine the way the chemistry of your body runs is that every single second there are billions of chemical reactions going off inside you. You don't have to instruct them. You don't have to wake up in the morning and say, oh, how are you going in there, energy cycles? Are you prepared to generate some energy for me today? You don't have to do that. It runs itself, provided it has the nutrients necessary to allow the reactions to occur. So here's a simple way to see it. Inside you, substance A is going to be converted into substance B in one biochemical reaction. But for substance A to become substance B, maybe you need magnesium and vitamin B6. And if you are deficient in either or both of those nutrients, then that reaction won't occur. And substance A will accumulate and you won't have enough substance B. Now, perhaps substance A, when it's at normal levels, it's no problem for your body. But when substance A starts to accumulate, it behaves like a poison to your body. And maybe you need substance B for great sleep, great energy, to use body fat as a fuel, or for a happy mood. In other words, when we become nutrient deficient, there are consequences to that. And I want you armed with that kind of nutrient know-how for the benefit of your own lives, the lives of your families, but also so you can have more meaningful conversations with people that you come into contact with. Because essentially with optimum nutrition, what we are trying to do is slow down the ways we age. And scientifically speaking, the ways we age are those listed there: oxidation, inflammation, and glycation. So we want to provide the body with the substances, with the nutrients that are essential to minimize how quickly these things are occurring inside our body, because that's how we take a powerful step and help others take a powerful vitamin A. It's a powerful antioxidant to mop up those free radicals, to prevent that oxidation and the oxidative stress in our body. It's critical for a healthy immune response, which we need not just to help us prevent colds and flus, but in the anti-tumor response, the anti-cancer response. Our immune system plays such a critical role in the quality and longevity of our lives. And of course, the carotene is critical for all the biochemical pathways involved in vision. We need the B vitamins, B1, B2, B3, for example. We need them for energy, so that when we consume food, that our body is able to extract energy from that and provide the cells of our body the energy to do what they have to do, so we can go out in the world and make a difference. There are more B vitamins, B6, B7, B9, also known as folate, and B12. They help facilitate the movement of carbon around the body. Now that sounds really boring, doesn't it? But if you think about carbon, its job is to help repair your DNA. Its job is to help create some of the neurotransmitters in your brain. Did you know that serotonin, one of our happy carbon-content hormones, 80 to 90% of that is actually made in the digestive system? So we must also, of course, take care of that digestive system, and probiotics go a long way towards that. The B vitamins also play a role in our body's ability to create hormones that actually allow us to sleep. So again, when you're having conversations with people about the things that they struggle with, you want to really hear them. You want to meet them where they're at. You want to help them solve the challenges that they're facing in their lives. And sleep can be a big one. So obviously we get our B vitamins from these extraordinary multi-essentials that we get in a package from USANA. They are outstanding. Vitamin C, also called ascorbic acid. As a nutritionist, we're kind of not supposed to have favourite nutrients. It would be like having favourite children. But if I really had to pick one, I think it is this one. Vitamin C plays so many extraordinary roles in the body, and we can't store it. We must consume it. It is so critical, again, for our immune function, for the growth and repair of the cells and tissues in our body. It's a powerful, powerful antioxidant. It's required for neurotransmitter production, and even our stress hormone regulation, which I'm going to talk a lot more about in the training stages tomorrow, it's also involved in that. Cortisol, one of our stress hormones, needs vitamin C to be created. And when people don't make enough cortisol because they've been stressed for such a long time, there's a lot of inflammation that gets created in the body. Cortisol is a powerful anti-inflammatory substance, but we must have adequate vitamin C for that to be able to be made. Of course, we get our vitamin C from our citrus fruits, but we also get it in such a highly bioavailable form in polyseed and my favourite, pro-vitamin C. Equaling 3. They have such a powerful synergistic effect. Now, when we talk about vitamin D, a lot of people think that as long as you get a little bit of exposure to the sun, you'll be okay. Because vitamin D certainly does get created when the sunlight acts on the cholesterol in our skin. And vitamin D can then be created if the liver and the kidneys do their job properly. However, there are countless studies out now, published now in peer-reviewed scientific literature, demonstrating that even though people might be getting adequate sun exposure, they still don't have optimum blood levels of vitamin D. So again, we must make sure we're getting that. We can get it in the vitamin D supplement on its own, but it's also present in the multi-essentials and then in that beautiful calcium supplement. The vitamin E, the fancy words for vitamin E are tocopherols and tocotrienols. And I tell you that just so that when you see labels, you can recognise those words as vitamin E. They're so important for skin health. They behave as an antioxidant. Again, slowing down that oxidative process in the body. And they support the healthy lining of our blood vessels. If we could call the lining of our blood vessels an organ, so if you think about the 96,000 kilometres of blood vessels that run through your body. If you can imagine imagine the lining of those blood vessels? If we call them an organ, that would be the biggest organ in the body. And vitamin E really steps up and helps our body take amazing care of the lining of those blood vessels. Such a critical role. Of course, we get vitamin E in the E5 supplement, something that I take every single day. So here across this extraordinary range of nutritional supplements, you're covering a whole lot of bases. You are covering a whole lot of processes that can otherwise, in this day and age, proceed at far too rapid rates. The nutrients in these supplements give your body what they need to slow down those aging processes, which is something, obviously, that everybody wants to do. The minerals in our body, calcium and magnesium. A lot of you are probably familiar with the fact that we need these minerals for fantastic bones and teeth and fingernails. What I think a lot of people don't understand is that these nutrients are critical for the biochemical processes in the body that enable us to relax. And with the amount of stress that people face these days in the world, obviously that is becoming more and more critical. It's very important for our nervous system to be able to function correctly and also for our muscles to be able to move. So every time I do this, calcium and magnesium swap places. And again, you don't even have to think about that. But you'll notice that if you cramp, that's your body giving you some feedback that something is amiss with that potential, with that mineral balance. And quite often, it's the magnesium that we're not getting enough of when we experience those cramps. Very, very common today. We obviously can support ourselves getting enough calcium, making sure we're covered with the active calcium. But before I move on from calcium, I just want to tell you an extraordinary story that, again, I think more and more people need to know about. So when people live on a diet of poor quality food, so a lot of processed food, a lot of things out of packets that are virtually devoid of nutrients, what can happen very slowly over time is, for want of a better word, rubbish can start to accumulate in our blood vessels. And as the rubbish starts to accumulate in the lining of the blood vessels, the actual structure of the blood vessels becomes weaker. And calcium is a strengthening agent for the body. So the more rubbish in our blood vessels, the more calcium the body recruits to harden those blood vessels up again. But it's not where we want it. We want the calcium doing the jobs I mentioned a moment ago, involved in the bones, the teeth, and the hair, and the nervous system. You don't want your body getting the message to recruit it to harden your blood vessels, because that puts your cardiovascular system under immense stress. So as we provide our body with the nutrients that we need, we must also be mindful of what's going in. We must be mindful of choosing more real whole food. Not only because of the nutrients that it gives us, but also because it stops us taking in some of those problematic substances. I take it a step further. You want to educate yourselves with Dr. Wentz's book, The Healthy Home, so that you can become familiar with the array of problematic substances that are out there and start to minimize your exposure to those things. All of those things are critical for amazing health and energy. We need iodine, we need selenium, we need zinc. They're critical for a lot of the biochemical pathways going on in the body. We need iodine and selenium in particular for great thyroid function, and my goodness, thyroid dysfunction is significantly on the rise in our world at the moment, and it doesn't need to be that way. We need these minerals for great immune function and for great hormone production and for hormone balance. The minerals copper, manganese, chromium, and molybdenum, we need them for things like blood glucose regulation and also to help our body eliminate the heavy metals that we're exposed to. So most definitely, we want to do what we can in our lives to minimize our exposure to things like heavy metals. But there are some things that we can't avoid. There are more cars on the road now than ever before, for example. So you've got to strengthen this extraordinary vehicle. I call it your earth suit. You've got to strengthen this vehicle so that it's able to effectively detoxify and eliminate the substances that you get exposed to in this day and age. And the minerals. So what are we trying to do overall by optimizing nutrition? I've said it once, I'll say it again, we're trying to slow down the aging process and help prevent degenerative disease. I truly love Dr. Wang's vision of believing in the world and putting every effort into the world to prevent degenerative disease. It is so unnecessary. And the work that you are all doing to communicate health messages, not only to your friends and family, but to your downlines and to the people that you are yet to meet, is going to make an enormous difference in that role. So critical. You want to focus on making sure that you're getting real food because of the nutrients, because of the antioxidants, and to help support great gut health. But it's also about what you miss out on, about the artificial substances, the preservatives. If you think about a preservative being in a food, it's there to extend the shelf life. It's there to stop bacterial growth. But you will all be familiar with the fact that you've got about 3 or 4 kilos of bacteria that live in your large intestine that play a critical role in gut health, in your immune system being able to do its job properly, and a whole host of other functions. And we essentially don't know the impact of some of these potentially problematic substances on things like the population of gut bacteria that are housed in there. We want to make sure we're not getting these fake food ingredients and foods that can drive inflammation. We have one body, and there is not another person on the planet that can step up and take care of it. You're the only one who can. We want to make sure that we're eliminating everything effectively. We want to make sure our detoxification pathways are working optimally. And Hepatol DTX goes a long way in supporting the biochemical pathways of the liver. The scientists that do the research and product development here at USANA are the best in the world. They truly understand the inner workings of the body. They have degrees in things like biochemistry. So they understand what providing the body with a particular nutrient in combination with another nutrient will do inside of us. They then have researched what allows those substances to be available to your body to utilize effectively. And that is a winning formulation. Great detoxification doesn't just involve, though, making sure we're having plenty of real food and giving the body the nutrients it needs for those detox pathways. It's also, of course, critical to support the kidneys in what they have to do. Your urine is your blood having been filtered. And the kidneys do that critical work, and hydration plays an enormous role in the health of your kidneys. Glycation, that other biochemical process I mentioned earlier, to minimize that, we want to make sure we're not consuming refined sugar and refined starches, because it's those substances that feed the glycation processes, which is one of the ways our DNA can be damaged. So before I finish today, I want to remind you of the extraordinary position that you as your associates are in. I want to remind you that the more knowledge you build, not only do you feel better yourselves, but you can foster such growth and change the quality of life of other people. I'm obsessed with the ripple effect. And it is so powerful here amongst the USANA family, actually witnessing that ripple effect in action. I believe that a big part of what we need to do as humans on the planet is to contribute and to make a difference in other people's lives. And when you are well nourished yourself, when you have got those nutrients going in, providing every cell in your body with precisely what it needs to do all of its critical work and keep you alive, because without nutrients you wouldn't be here. As long as you're providing your body with that, you get the benefits of that, of reducing your risk of developing disease, enhancing your energy, but then being able to contribute and go out and make an enormous difference in the lives of others through what you teach them, but also with how you show up. And I thank you for that. Go out and continue to change the world.